EUI injectors take low-pressure supply fuel and pressurize the fuel between 10,000 and 30,000 psi. A camshaft-operated rocker arm pushes down the injector tappet and plunger, supplying the mechanical energy required to pressurize and pump the fuel from the injector. The combustion chamber receives pressurized fuel in the correct quantity and at the correct injection timing. The extremely high-pressure fuel flow through small orifice holes in the tip causes the fuel to atomize into microscopic droplets that burn more completely. This improved combustion more efficiently uses the heat energy of the fuel, resulting in improved fuel economy and reduced exhaust emissions. The low-pressure fuel system supplies fuel from the tank to the injectors. This system has three basic functions: to supply fuel to the EUI injectors for combustion, to supply extra fuel flow for cooling of the injectors, and to supply extra fuel flow to remove air from the system. The major components in the typical low-pressure fuel system are the vehicle fuel tank, the fuel transfer lines, the primary fuel filter or water separator, the fuel transfer pump, the secondary fuel filter and priming pump, and the pressure regulator valve. There are often component differences between the fuel tank and transfer pump on different engine arrangements and applications. For example, the recommended arrangement for most truck engines utilizes a 15 to 30 micron primary filter to catch large debris from the fuel tank. However, some truck manufacturers do not install a primary filter and instead rely solely on the secondary filter. Fuel drawn from the tank flows to the primary fuel filter or water separator. The primary filter screens large debris before the fuel flows to the inlet side of the fuel transfer pump. This is a simple gear pump containing an integral pressure relief valve. Fuel pressure is typically limited to between 60 and 125 psi. Excess fuel flows from the pressure relief valve on the outlet side of the pump through an internal passage to the inlet side of the pump. Fuel flows from the outlet port of the transfer pump to the secondary fuel filter. In the past, secondary filters typically had 10 to 15 micron ratings. Most 1999 and newer engines use 2 micron fuel filters. The very small, abrasive fuel contaminants which cause premature wear out of the injectors. The fuel filter base also contains a hand-operated fuel priming pump. The purpose of the priming pump is to refill the system with fuel and remove air from the low-pressure fuel supply system after a filter change or injector replacement. The priming pump pulls the transfer pump and into the filter. It then pushes fuel through the supply, removes the very small, abrasive fuel contaminants, which cause premature wear-related fuel priming pump. The purpose of the priming pump is to refill the system with fuel and remove air from the low-pressure fuel supply system after a filter change or injector replacement. The priming pump pulls the filter. It then pushes fuel through the supply in the cylinder head and back to the tank. Fuel flows from the secondary fuel filter to the supply passage in the cylinder head. On the 3406E, the fuel supply passage is a drilled hole extending from the front to the back of the cylinder head. On the C10, C12, a manifold on the side of the engine supplies fuel to each injector and returns excess flow back to tank. Excess fuel flows into the fuel pressure regulator. The fuel pressure regulator consists of a spring-loaded check valve. This pressure relief valve opens at approximately 60 psi and regulates pressure in a range of 60 to 125 psi. When the engine is off and no fuel pressure is present, the spring-loaded check closes to prevent the fuel in the cylinder head from draining back to the tank. Retaining fuel in the head maintains a supply of fuel for the injectors at engine startup. Most 1999 and newer EUI engines use a new electronic control system. This state-of-the-art system has many features and benefits. Although this presentation focuses on major electronic engine component operation, some basic electronic diagnostics are covered in the diagnostics portion of this presentation. The electronic control system consists of three types of components: input, control, and output. Sensors constantly monitor engine operating conditions and relay that information back to the electronic control module. The ECM is the computer that controls the engine. It has three main functions. It provides power for the engine electronics. It monitors input signals from engine sensors, and it acts as a governor to control engine RPM. It also stores engine operating information, such as faults, events, and cumulative operating hours. The personality module is the software in the ECM, which contains the specific maps that define power, torque, and RPM of the engine. The ECM sends electrical currents to output devices to control engine operation. The heart of the electronic system is the new electronic control module. This powerful, state-of-the-art computer controls all engine functions, providing excellent performance and fuel economy while meeting stringent and ever-changing exhaust emission standards. The ECM provides many electronic features, including full authority electronic engine control, logging of engine faults, improved electronic engine diagnostics, electronic cruise control, programmable electronic PTO, engine monitoring and protection, and more than 100 programmable features. The new ECM has two 70-pin harness connectors, the engine harness connector and the vehicle harness connector. Older engines used an ECM with two 40-pin connectors. The engine harness connects the ECM to all of the sensors and actuators, including the EUI injectors. The vehicle harness connects the ECM to the engine control portion of the main vehicle harness. This includes the accelerator pedal position sensor, vehicle speed sensor, transmission, brake and clutch switches, cruise control and PTO control switches, data links, check engine and warning lights, engine retarder switches, speedometer and tachometer, and cooling fan solenoid. This wiring may seem complicated, but it's really quite simple. All of it is made up of many simple circuits. We will cover some of these circuits in the electronic system operation portion of this presentation. Sensors are simple electronic devices that detect and convert a change in pressure, temperature, or mechanical movement into an electrical signal. There are four basic types of sensors: pressure, temperature, position, and speed. Thank you.